Hello, everybody. It's day 6, and we're going to be working inside the van today. So come on, let's go.
Today, we're going to be putting in a new stereo and some speakers, because I got a new one, and I am really excited for music. So let's get cracking. Yeah.
So the first thing you want to do before you start messing with your speakers and your stereo is disconnect the negative terminal on your battery. That'll prevent you from getting shocked in case there's electrical short or whatever. And don't exactly want to get electrocuted, right?
Now, one thing I noticed about all the YouTube videos I watched is they all showed you how to take out the factory stereo, but they didn't show you how to take out the aftermarket stereo. So we're gonna do that today, and hopefully I can figure it out. So let's give it a shot. I'm pretty sure you take this thingy off first. So let's give it a shot. Let's see. Almost took the whole stereo off. Cool.
I'm doing it.
I'm doing something. Doesn't matter if this one breaks because, well, it's a broken one. The volume just keeps blasting too loud. I must be getting too old. Whole thing's coming out. This is gonna be a lot easier than I thought it is. Like the whole thing's coming out. Huh. Well, there you go, kids. That was really easy. Neat! I did it! So all you need is a screwdriver. Alright, well, I'm still going on it. Figured I'd show you guys what I saw. I guess normally they don't come out like that, maybe not. But I knew about these side things here. These are like the clips. And I guess each mounting kit comes with like keys you kind of slide in there. Still gotta get this thing off though. Hang on, bear with me. Come on, I feel a little bastard. There we go. So yeah, this comes off first. You can see that. Yeah, and then it's got these little things. You slide like keys into there and it'll pop this little thing out. But since we already got to the side, just pop that out a little bit like that. And same on this side. And then you're supposed to do something else. Ah, I guess slide that off. Okay, and then the whole thing comes off. So I guess this is the mounting thingamabobber here itself. So I guess I gotta take all these wires off next. All right, so I managed to get them all off. So I'm just gonna show you guys the wires that I unplugged. So this one was plugged into this one. And it's like, I took this one out of the back. It was just plugged in right to here. Just kind of pop that right out. Well, this one was also attached to here. Yeah, like that. So I have no idea what any of these do, but maybe it'll help you. Yay! And so now, I'm gonna take this part off. I think we'll keep that. Old radio we don't really need anymore, so set that down there. And then next up is hooking up the new radio. So we're going to try that. All right, now that we have the old stereo out, it's time to put the new one in. All right, so as you can see on the back of the new stereo, there's all these little wires. This was from the old stereo, and you can see this connector attaches right here. But it's attached to this little thing that went to the old stereo, so we gotta take all these apart and connect them to here so we can plug in to here. So basically, gotta take this one off and then attach this one to all these. So here's a time lapse so you guys can see how I do that. got the old stereo out, our next step is to get everything that's in our way out of our way. For two reasons. Number one, so we can get out the old speakers, take them out, and put the new speakers in. And two, so we can get the new wiring back to here, so when we put the new stereo in, everything is good to go. Our next step, we're going to take off that door panel on the passenger side so we can get out the old speaker.
For this exercise, you're going to need a Phillips head screwdriver, a socket wrench, and a flathead screwdriver, and some sockets.
All right, guys, the next step is to take off the door panel so we can get at the front speaker. The first step, well, first you're gonna need either a flathead screwdriver or a Phillips head, or both. Now what we're gonna do is we're gonna take off this little thingy first. All you gotta do is kind of shift it up and then pry out. There we go. Yeah, see there's a little clip right there. Let me zoom in. Yeah, so that's what holds it in place. You just kind of up and pop out. And then you can see right here, there's another little screw I'm gonna take out. So this is the first screw we're gonna take out. Now make sure to throw these away because you'll never need them again. Right. Where did I throw that? All right, next we're gonna take off this screw right here. It's right behind the door. Kind of a little harder to get at. Down here is the one where you're gonna need the flathead. So grab that, wherever the hell I put it. So let's go ahead and pop that little thingy off there, and then you got your Phillips right there. Now, next what we gotta do is pop this little thingy up because there's another screw hidden underneath. So you get your flathead and pop her up. And see there's a screw right here you gotta take out. You able to see that? And grab your Phillips. All right, and the next thing you gotta do is pop this little section off because I think there's another screw behind there. A lot of screws. Just kind of slide it over. There you go. Alright, and then if my calculations are correct, you want to tuck this in so you're not like ripping that out. Lift straight up and make sure this doesn't get caught because you don't want to rip that off. And there we go, that's how you take off the door. All right, you can see mine still had like a lot of the cover because I guess this door has never been taken off before, except for once when I replaced the mirrors. But we're gonna go ahead and take this off here so we can work behind it. There's a lot of stuff behind there we need to work on. So go ahead and rip this off. You can keep it if you want, unless you're gonna be working on stuff, but it's annoying me. Again, be careful with the lock mechanism. You don't wanna accidentally rip that. So just gonna slide that up right through. All right, so here's all the interior. Now here's the speaker that we're gonna be working on. So we're just gonna go ahead and unscrew all these and take it out. That's the next step. Okay, so it's like these have like kind of specialty screws. You can also use a really tiny socket, but these have like kind of the star-shaped screws you gotta use. So luckily my brother had an adapter, so we can just go ahead and get these out. So we got the speaker unscrewed. Now what you gotta do is just unplug it. And you see this little thing right here? It's pushed down, comes right out. And that's how you take your speakers out of your Ford Econoline van. Next up, we're gonna be putting the speaker in. A new one! Okay, so this is my new speaker. Now, it came with these little adapters, so you can just plug right into the existing, like the factory adapter.
And if you look right here, it's like it connected to these little two little doohickeys right here. Well, the adapter was like a little bit too small on this one, so we got one of these. These are just like little adapters you can get like right at Lowe's or AutoZone or something like that, and then just crimp the wire and put it right on there and you're good to go. So pretty much now we just plug it right in and we'll screw it in. All right, so we're gonna put the speaker in now. It's all, the wires are all hooked up. And you wanna make sure obviously your holes are lined up to where you can screw them in. That's kind of important. So go ahead. Hey guys, it's day 7, and today's goal is to get this speaker in. It actually has wires already ran back to it. I might have to do some splicing because the adapters I have aren't fitting it. So that's one of the goals for today. And the other goal is to take out that ceiling where the dome light is and all that stuff right there, so I can start running wire to those side cargo doors and then this door right here, because I gotta run wire back to here. So this is gonna get interesting. Again, never done this before, so you're gonna learn with me. So first we're gonna tackle this speaker right here. Okay, I'm gonna show you guys what I was doing yesterday with the speaker. All right, you can see how they have these little two little hookups right here. So here's the little wires and they go on here. So you just gotta put these on. Sometimes you gotta pry them up because they're either too small or they just need to adjust a little bit. So we'll see if we can get these to fit right away. Obviously big goes with big, little goes with little. So, and this is positive and this is negative. So. There we go. And so now we're all set up on the speaker and we know which is positive and negative. So positive on at least this particular speaker is white, and negative is white with a black stripe. Typically, if it has a black stripe, it's negative. So that's how you set up the speaker for installation. So next up, we're gonna try to figure out how to install it then. Okay, so next we're gonna start splicing this and hooking it up to the speaker. So I don't know if you can see it that well, but one is yellow and red, and the other one is purple and black. Now, if you remember what I said, black is typically negative, so the purple and black is the negative one, and the yellow and red is the positive. Typically, red will signify positive also. So we're gonna go ahead and cut this, and then we're gonna try splicing it together with the speaker. All right, you can see I stripped the wires down to the copper. I did that on both of them. See that? Now next step is putting them together. So I bought these closed end connectors. They're the same thing that you use with the stereo. At least that's what mine came with. Really easy to use. You just stick both pieces of the wire together and you like kind of twist them and then you just shove them down there and then you just kind of crimp them together. And I'm hoping this will work. We'll see. Also, to strip wires, it's really easy to do if you've never done it before. You just take your wire strippers, this little wire stripper, and see how these numbers right here? These are the gauge of wire. And so you just put the right gauge of wire, and like they'll usually say if they don't, and you just use your best guess, just kind of put them in the hole right there. And then put it together, and then you just kind of pull straight up. And then you get the little casing to come off, and you want to have the copper wire right there. So we're going to go ahead and try to put these together and hope for the best. Wanted to pause for a second to show you it's raining outside pretty hard. Perfect time to be doing electrical work, right? Remember what I said about the battery and the taking off the negative lead? Well,
This would be one of the reasons why.
Hey guys, it's day 8, and I went to Lowe's and got some supplies. So I got some flex tubing. This stuff goes over the wires and stuff, kind of keeps it like, you know, from friction and insulated and whatnot. Electrical tape, obviously. I got some more of the closed-end connectors and like some butt connectors. Butt connector. I also got some cable clamps so I can like just kind of, well, you see how like the factory already ran it along there? Well, I guess I'm going to be doing that with those. Of course, I got my crimpers, and I got some zip ties because I have a feeling I'll be using a lot of those. So anyway, yesterday I got the speakers in. Yeah, I got that speaker in, and today is we're gonna take all this stuff out and hopefully be able to run some wire from the stereo back to that side one right there, because there was no wiring to put a speaker in there. And then we still have to do one for the side cargo doors as well. So I gotta take all the ceiling out and possibly some of where the seat belts are, so I can run the wiring for those. So that's gonna get interesting. Here we go. Okay guys, so I just got the ceiling off, and I just made an important discovery. Once I finished the ceiling, I was like, where's all the wires at? And then I traced the one wire back to where I think it's going, and I'm like, boy, I hope I'm not right. Well, it turns out I was. So if you come over here, all right, see this little steppy thingy? It's got these little clippy things, you just pop right out. And lo and behold, there are the wires that are run. It goes up and then goes up the side and then it goes down the back. So basically, I just took off the ceiling for no reason. The more you know. Anyway, well, lesson learned. Now, I'm gonna take a break, drink a beer, and then we're gonna figure this out.
Hey guys, it's day 9. Saw yesterday me take down the interior ceiling, and I thought that was a complete waste. Well, it turns out it wasn't a complete waste. I'm still taking the roof racks and I'm going to be bolting them through the ceiling, so I actually did need to take those down, so a little bit of relief there. Today I'm going to be taking these out so I can run the wiring up, so I gotta undo the seat belts and then take off these plastic thingamabobbers right here. And once I get those done on both sides, then we can start the wiring finally. First thing to get the seat belts off, you want to take this thing off. It just pops right off. So, and then you can get access to the bolt right here. So let me get the right socket and then we'll see what happens next. Okay, it turns out it was a 5/8 socket. So that's for the 2005 Ford Econoline E250. For the seat belts. So if you happen to have one and that helps you, awesome. I'm doing my job then. So here we go, time lapse of me getting this in done. Okay, now we gotta figure out how to get this part off. So okay, that was easy. I guess it's just got those interior clips, like a lot of the other stuff, so you just pop it right off. Well, that was easy. Okay, now for the bottom portion. I don't know if this one's gonna be as easy. We'll see. I don't know if you can see right here, there's a little thingamabobber like before, so I'm gonna get the screwdriver. Yeah, it's one of those. Tires. Trying to stay out of the way of the camera and do this is kind of tricky. So I apologize if I'm taking up the entire screen. I just have a big star personality. There we go. Yeah, it's one of those little, they just kind of pop those little things out. All right, so that goes to that one. And let's see what we got. Holy crap, I did it! All right, yeah, so just a couple little clips holding that on, and then this little thing. So that's pretty easy. Remember these little clips right here, so they just kind of pop right in and out. So yeah, that was actually a lot easier than I thought it was gonna be. Cool. All right, now we gotta do the other side. So, all right. Okay, so, okay, maybe they don't just pop off, but there's little clips on the back, so you just kind of pop them up. That one I was able just to pry off because like the clips were kind of broken. But yeah, you just kind of pop these off from the back like you just saw me do. So, now here's a time lapse of me taking out this whole side.
Everybody, it's day 10 and we're finally ready to start wiring. I'm so excited. So let me show you what we're gonna do. If you remember from last time, the step down is where we found the wire, right? So what we gotta do today is take out this thing. So we have plenty of room to wire. We're gonna start at the stereo, work our way over, down, back, up, back with the wire. We're gonna tape it up, clamp it, make it look nice. And then what we're gonna do is hook up that back rear cargo door speaker. I'm so excited to rock! Now what we're gonna do is go over to the other side, do the exact same thing, but with the side cargo doors. Hook up that speaker, and then we're gonna throw out the Thunderstruck, and then we're gonna rock and have a good time, because I feel great, yeah!
All right, guys, it's day 12. You can see what I did yesterday is I clipped up all the flex tube with the speaker wire in it and got it all the way to the back. And I came to here and I'm like, oh man, I gotta get like another part. Luckily, my dad has a broken down van that I was able to get this out of. So now I'm just gonna attach this to here, run the wire through, and then we can put the speaker in. So here we go. Another idea I had for this was you should get like some rigid tubing, like, you know, fish tank tube or like little really tiny PVC pipe, and you take it through here and then you could just run it through the PVC pipe and then I actually get through. But, or you could just massage it, giggity.
Or you can just get a brother that can do anything that the little brother can't.
Okay, guys, so I want to show you what like I was doing with the speakers. You can get these little things. A lot of times they'll come with the speaker. Sometimes they won't. Sometimes they'll be a little bit too small. So what you want to do is like just go ahead and put these ones right on there. There you go, until it clicks. And kind of see they're stuck in good in place. And then what we're going to do is they're just the same as those butt connectors or those closed end connectors. Just stick the wire in and then you crimp it tight and you want to tug it a little bit just to make sure it's going to stay in place. Just really enough little tug so it's like, you know, okay, it's in there, not enough like a big yank. So next up, we're going to go ahead and hook these up to the door and we'll be good to go.
Take me home. Coming in, please.